All right? It's like we cannot say anfusikum instead of anfusakum. If it's fatha, you have to read it fatha. You can't change it. Okay? Because it's changed the meaning, and it's also you are not following Sunnatullah al-Nabi alayhi salatu wasalam. Now, that was the obvious mistake. Now, we have another kinds of mistakes that we call it hidden mistake. What is the hidden mistake? Who has any idea about the hidden mistake? Al-lahn al-khafi. Al-lahn al-khafi is you are not reading with mad four counts. You are not doing the gunna. Inna al-ladhina. This is a hidden mistake. Why was it called hidden mistake? Because only the people who learn the tajweed knows that here we have a mistake for tajweed rules. It's called hidden mistake. But the rest of the people who never learned a tajweed, if you read in front of them, say inna al-ladhina amanu, yeah, correct, mashallah, excellent, no mistakes. But the one who learned tajweed say, no, you didn't do ghunna here, you didn't do enough time in this word, and so on. Hidden mistake, is it halal, or is it mustahab, or is it dislikable, or is it a haram? It is dislikable. It is makruh. Yukrah an taqra al-Qur'an bidun tajweed. It is dislikable to read al-Qur'an without tajweed if you know the rules. Like you finish the dawra of tajweed and you know how to read it very well, mashallah. And then when you are by yourself reading, say, وَقَالَتْ بِيَهُدُ لَيْسَتَ نَصَارَ عَلَى شَيْءٍ وَقَالَتْ النَّصَارَ لَيْسَتْ لِيَهُدُ عَلَى شَيْءٍ. No. This is dislikable. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is watching you and listening to you, and He hates this reading. Al yaqul an-nabi alayhi salatu wasalam, inna Allah yuhibbu an yuqra al-Qur'ana ghaddan kama unzil. Ghaddan, fresh, not changing the way it was revealed to him. This is how Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet likes this Qur'an to be read it in this way. Okay, so now in our dawra here, we are, the first thing, our main goal, no obvious mistakes. Try to give you some rules of tajweed that will help you to start reading Al-Quran the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and His Prophet likes it to be recited, inshallah. So the first thing we said last time was that we have النون المشددة والميم المشددة. The noon that has shadda and the meme that has shadda. These two letters, whenever we have them in Al-Quran, inshallah, we are trying to read it with a ghunna. What is ghunna? Do you remember what is ghunna? Rana, ghunna. It's a sound that comes from the nose. And when you have the noon mushaddada and noon mushaddada, you have to apply this ghunna and make it a little bit long. Like, don't say, inna alladhina. إن الذين say إن الذين عما يتساءلون عما say عما يتساءلون عما. You give it this غنة. This is ABC تجويد.
Yeah,
go ahead.
Now, since in Ramadan we are reading Quran like so many times, should we have like to stop in each letter, do ghunna or like?
Yes, but let me tell you something. We have speeds in reading. You have speeds in reading. We have three levels of speeding. Al-hadr, which is very fast, you go fast. And at-tawassut, that means you are medium, not very fast, not very slow. And we have at-tahqiq, that you are reading slowly, the way we are reading here. As you say, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. This is tahqiq. Let's do tawassut. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. Let's go حذر. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. The only thing that I want you to pay attention to it, that I am applying all the rules of tajweed, but the speed is going differently. مستمعة. أهلا سيستر كمان. أهلا أهلا. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله وبركاته. عليكم السلام ورحمة الله. Have a seat please. You can. Yeah. If I want to read Surah Al-Fatiha, I will say with Al-Hadr, you say Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen. Definitely I will not choose Tahqiq in Ramadan. Because it will take a really long time. Let's go to At-Tawassut. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. الحمد لله رب العالمين. Let's go to Hadar. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. But I will not accept. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين. No. No. This you are not giving any حق. For the letters and you don't understand what you're saying.
No, we do understand. I mean, but not that fast, as you say. In the middle between the first one and the last.
Go with Hadar, only Hadar, yeah. And يعني you read each letter course, correctly. Yeah. But not.
I'm not having any rules actually. Yeah.
Okay. For example, yes, الجزء بياخد 20 minutes to read it. 20 to 22 minutes. What we consider that from the levels?
Hadar. Hadar. This is Hadar.
20.
يعني المفروض ياخذ half an hour for example. لا حدر is good. 20 minutes is حدر good.
يعني البقرة بتاخذ 1 hour. So
yes, that's enough. That's
جزء and half.
Yeah, 1 hour is good with حدر. Yes. If you do it less than that, that means you are yeah. خلاص فهمتوا. Did you understand now?
I have a question.
Go ahead.
I don't know about تجويد rules. I try to learn a little bit here and there. So if I'm reading and if I'm not making the major mistakes, is my reading not being accepted?
Of course it's accepted. What I'm talking about when you know the rules of tajweed, and you know it very well, and you learned it, and you know how to read with tajweed. And when you come to read by yourself, you do not read it. You will just read normally without any kind of rule. This is dislikable.
Okay.
But if you don't know the rules and you never heard about the rules, and you are reading it the way you know it, making sure that you are not doing any obvious mistakes, of course it's acceptable. And of course Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala likes your reading, but it is your responsibility.
It's obligatory, I wanted to say that, for each Muslim to learn tajweed.
To learn tajweed.
I heard.
As long as you have the chance, as long as you have the people, as long as you have the capability to go and learn, you have to. You have to. For everything we go. Swimming, go. Yoga, moga, gym, hada, yes. You always have the time to go and do it. So what about علم الآخرة? We have, and believe me, sisters, when you start learning at tajweed, you will have a different taste in reading the Quran. Totally different, right, Rana? Right? Because she's the one who learned with me tajweed, the whole thing, and Sister Iman too. Okay? طيب, now. We started with النون المشددة with الميم المشددة. Every time we have نون مشددة, ميم مشددة, you have to read it with غنة. And we said, what is غنة? Yes, it's a sound that comes out from the nose. And you have to give it a little bit of time. If you are reading with تحقيق, which is very slow, give it like 4 counts. إِنَّ الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا. Now, this is the first thing. The other, the second rule I told you about was al-mad. Al-mad, the sign of mad that is followed by hamza. Look at that poster over there. You will see al-mad when it is followed by hamza. You have to pull that mad 4 counts. Let's see the word ma'in. Meem, fatha, and then the alif, you say ma-in, su-in, or su-a, su-a, ji-a, ji-a. Why are you doing it 4 counts? Because this mad is followed by hamza. Any mad followed by hamza, we pull it 4 counts. If I never learned this rule, would I do that? I wouldn't. That is, like here we have أولئك ما كان لهم. If I don't know the rule, I would say أولئك ما كان لهم. But no, we have mad followed by hamza. Ulaika. All right? This is very simple rules I'm giving you now. What other rule we talked about yesterday? We talked about al-qalqala. Qutbijad. If you look at that poster behind you, here in front of you, we have five letters. Qaf, ta, ba, jim, dal. Qutbijad. Whenever we have sukoon on these letters, what do?
Shake it.
We shake it. You then say, you don't say aq, you say aqo. You don't say at, you say ato. With the ba, how do you say it? Aba. Very good, Rabia. With the jim?
Aj.
Aj. With the dal?
Ad.
Ad. Very good. Who can read the first word here? Naqan. Do you say naqan or naqan?
Naqan.
Okay, Sister Muna, do number two, the next one, batsha.
Batsha.
Very good. Sister Iman?
Subhan.
Subhan, excellent. Sister Fadwa?
Tajiri.
Tajiri, excellent. Rana?
Adihan.
Allahu Akbar. Okay, Sister Rabia, can you say uqsim?
Uqsim.
Allahu Akbar. Now you are good at Qatala, mashallah. Okay, sister?
Mamahar.
Mamahar, ahla wa sahla, yes. Wasat.
Wasatu.
Na.
Wasatu.
Wasatu, na. Very good. Sister Rima?
I can see.
Far?
Faragab.
Again.
Faragab.
La, say it again.
Faragab.
Farghab.
Farghab.
Yes. Farghab.
Farghab.
Very good. Sister Nicole?
Zajaratun.
Allahu Akbar. Mumtaz, ya Nicole. Zajaratun. Excellent. Sister Muna? La, who did not, Rana, who did not get a chance to read? Fadwa. Yalla, Fadwa.
Yadkhulun.
Allahu Akbar. Yadkhuluna. Alhamdulillah. So we agree, all of us, we have the ghunna, the mad, and the qalqala. Today, inshallah, before we start, we are going to have also another rule, and it is, by the way, I am not giving everything about these rules. I'm just giving you an idea. It will help you to read it this way. Inshallah, in the future, we will have more details. Now, we have also another rule which is very important and make a big difference in your reading, which is called al-tafkhim, mm-hmm. or al-isti'la, okay? Now, al-isti'la is a rule, or you can say it's a quality of the letters. It's quality of the letters. We have seven letters in the Quran that when we read them, we have to elevate the back of the tongue in order to have a heavy sound. These seven letters are in the phrase khussa dagtin qidh. Khussa dagtin qidh. Kha, sad, dad, ghain, ta, qaf, dha. These seven letters, whenever you see them in Quran, you cannot read them with your tongue lowered. Because if you do not elevate the back of the tongue, instead of saying kha, you say kha. There is not such a thing kha in the Quran. You say kha, khalidina. Yes, khalidina. Or khudrun, khu, khu, not khu, khu. Okay? Tamam. Jinija and the sad. Sadaqa. Sa, sadaqa. Or sabir, sa. You don't say sa, sabir. No, it is sa. And the ghain. Ghairi al-maghdubi. Ghairi, not ghairi gha. If you put your tongue, the back of your tongue, if you lower it, you will have gha. If you elevate it, you will have gha. Let me hear from you gha.
Ghairi al-maghdubi.
Again?
Ghairi al-maghdubi.
Very good.
غير المغضوب.
ما شاء الله.
غير المغضوب.
Heavier.
غير.
Yes, that's very good.
غير المغضوب.
Very good.
غير المغضوب. غير المغضوب.
غير المغضوب.
Very good. That's better. You have to elevate the back of your tongue. Raise it a little bit. The back of the tongue. Here is the tongue. Here. You elevate this part. And it should touch here a little bit. If you not touch it, but it's going to be very close to the upper mouth roof. Say gha. Not gha. Gha. Very good. غيري.
غير المغضوب.
Okay.
غير المغضوب.
ما شاء الله.
غير المغضوب.
غير المغضوب.
Sister Medina.
غير المغضوب.
Very good. So let's go to the ta. A lot of people, they read it ta, ta, ta. The ta, you have to. Ta, 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 ta. طابقا. طابع. طابع. Okay, let's go. Ta, the qaf. Qala. 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 You can say qala, qala. Qala. Or yaqulu. Okay, let's go to va. Zalimina. Zalimina. Zulima. Zulima. There is not zalimina, the va. So these are the seven letters that we call them the letters of isti'la or elevation. The sound that comes out of it, of the elevation, is tafkhim, heaviness, heavy, heavy sound. What about the rest of the alphabets? Lowness, tarqiq, except for three letters, inshallah, we will talk about them later. So this is the general rule of at-tafkhim. Tamam? Let's start all over now, not all over. Let's continue, inshallah, resume our recitation. Bearing in mind that we will apply these rules that we were talking about. Al-ghunna, al-mad, al-qalqala, wa al-tafhim. All right? Inshallah. Okay, where did we stop? Which ayah was? Ayah number 106? Ma nansakh?
Ma nansakh.
Okay. Tfadal, Sister Anna? يلا. And we also talked about الاستعادة والبسملة. We'll see how are we going to start now, Sister Rana.
أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. ما ننسخ من آية أو ننسها نأتي بخير منها أو مثلها. ألم تعلم أن الله على كل شيء قدير؟